Hi, welcome to our channel. Today we are going to discuss about the cash flow statement. So cash flow, what is the cash flow statement, why we need it, and how it is benefit to our other as other financial statement like profit and loss balance sheet. Cash flow statement comes after the balance sheet and profit and loss, and generally people see only the balance sheet and profit and loss and make up their minds about the business. How the business is performing, what we are getting an year on year profit, and what is the EBITDA, earning profit, interest and tax, and other net profit and net profits ratio, as well as the gross profit ratios. We also see that the what the company having equities and what's the their retained earning position in the financial statement. The people see only those two things, profit and loss of balance sheet, and their make up mind that about the and predict about the futurability of the company. They did not do even though go through the cash statement. However, it is necessary to prepare the cash flow statement as per IFRS and accounting standard. So there is a two type of cash flow. One is direct cash flow. Second is indirect cash flow. So direct cash flow means in the direct cash flow process, major heads of cash inflows and outflows such as cash received from debtors, payment to creditors and other expenses are considered. While in case of indirect cash flow start from the profit and loss and add back to other operating activities, generation activities and then financing activities. So these all the expenses and incomes are covered, measured. This divided into three parts is operating activities, investing and financing activities. So sum up of all these activities add on to the profit and loss and define that it's an whether we are getting a net in cash generation or in cash generation in positive or negative. Statement is prepared on the basis of the following. Basically, these are the major requirement. That is, one is the regulatory requirement. So, regulatory requirements. Any whenever we prepare the statement, as per the accounting standards, either say IFRS or Ind AS, it is requirement to be prepare the cash flow statement. So, along with the financial statement like balance sheet, P&L notes and accounts, we have to prepare the cash flow as well. Second, the purpose is to understand the business analysis to where the cash is coming and going. So the cash is going into the operating activities or coming from operating activities. What is coming from the my financing activities and investing activities. Third one is to identify the cash generation capability of the business. Suppose it's a business getting more cash from this operating activities, means business is running fine. So we are not dependent on the other financing and investing activities. It's a very good tools to analyze the business. So it's so that where you are getting the cash, whether it's you are getting the cash from the financing or investing or as we have explained earlier. And the second is to help and to help the business to take the decision in immediate remedies to actions. Suppose sometimes where we require to cash for the short term purpose, we are going negative cash generation, then we can take the decision immediately and we can save the business to go into the trap. Now we will take one example to understand why the cash flow is the most important part to analyze any business. I have prepared one statement, finance statement in the business central for analyzing purpose. We just go from this one income statement. So first we will see the income statement, then balance sheet and then cash flow. So we'll just go to find income statement. Just to print this one, income statement for financial year 2020. Just to preview this one. So when we see the P&L profit and loss, we find that the company turnover is 2,17,000 and we are net earning is 35,000. So it's good profits. Company showing is a good profit. If you see about the gross profit, that the gross profit is 1,01,000 out of 2,17,000. So it's a half 50% approx the gross profit is, and I believe it's a 20% is approx 20% is a net profit is there. So it's a good sign for the company that company is earning a 16% 70% net profit on their sales. So it's seeing that company profitability and company's prospect is good, very good. Now when we go to the second slide for the balance statement. Again, the company financial position is very good. The company has total net worth is 3,18,000, means where they are the retained earning 2,94,000, and the common stock is equity is 24,000, and its current assets is again a good sign, because current assets is 4,09,000 with respect to its current liability, that is it's 3,11,000. So in the years, that is EBITDA, earning profit before interest and depreciation, that is 83,000 company earn. Out of 83,000, the company has paid 58,000 for the financing activity, means long term liabilities and finance cost. And during the period, the company has earned only on 18,000 is out of operating expenses. So having the turnover of 2,17,000, and the company has earned only 18,000 from the operating activities, means maximum amount of this operating income is stuck in the debtors and the stock. So we are not generating even enough cash to meet out our the liabilities part. So so it's an alarming situation for the company to understand that why the company's net earning is in minus 100, even though the company has profit is a very good high. So then we can go into the detail and understand upon the finance statement why, what is the reason behind it. Then this is a good sign. If you don't go to the cash flow statement, we do not know that the company's cash generation capacity is good or not. So that's why it's important to understand, to go the cash flow statement and to see the cash flow capabilities of the company and analyze for the analyzing of the business. Thank you.